Hey, this is Swedish Guitar Nerd, and today I'm taking a closer look at the Harley Benton SC Custom with P90s. Yeah, let's go! At the top, where do we start? But with the Grover tuners that are included in this guitar. They're really nice and smooth. To be completely honest, I actually prefer the unbranded Harley Benton ones, because these are, I don't know, the feel is, I don't know, soft, easy to move. The other ones seem more solid, but they are really nice, they are really good. We have a mahogany neck with a volute, as they have on all their set-in guitars, basically. Very good, nice work there. A nice and flat Rose Acer fretboard, treated maple. It's not as dark as on the CST24, but it's still, yeah, it's tinted brown at least. We have a 5-ply binding on the headstock. We have a single ply binding on the neck and a 7-ply binding on the body. It looks really fancy. Mahogany neck, mahogany body, two Wilkinson P90 pickups, and I don't know, Far Eastern sheepish looking bridge. I'll get back to that one. Three-way switch, volume, and tone. And a really solid output jack, as with all the Harley Bentons I've tried in this run. This one also comes standard with strap locks that are kind of interesting to work with, but yeah, it's better than nothing. Yeah. So that's good. Included in the price. Well, what did I forget? Nothing, I think. It's all gold and nice, and all the bindings yellow, tinted yellow. Materials and hardware, I give it a 7. When it comes to build quality, you start noticing why this guitar costs nothing. I should point out, I didn't say that at the beginning, this is a B-stock guitar. And I'm not really sure why it's B-stock. Probably, my guess is that it's just a return guitar, because I can't really find the flaws that would make someone send it back. There is a small dent up here, but that's all. Apart from that, the finish job, which is actually much nicer on this SC Custom than on the CST24. It's much more mirror-like and flat and nice. On the body it's okay, maybe? They haven't followed the binding, really. And it's much worse on the neck, because here it's not straight at all. The headstock, I mean, here there are parts there you can't even see the binding. So where you're sitting, it probably looks nice, but if you look up close, it's kind of a mess. But yeah, and the bridge. I mentioned this in the unboxing video. These posts aren't completely into the body. That's not a good thing. They are supposed to be. So, build quality durability, I gave it a 7. Again, the volute on the neck should make your headstock stay on, not break off. Playability, the neck is really nice. I really like the neck of this one. I mean, this is a Gibson style ESP Eclipse copy style Les Paul guitar. And the ESP guitars are, of course, have really slim necks, and the Gibson ones usually have really chubby necks. And this is more in the ESP family. So it's really nice and slim, easy to play. Really like it. Of course, since it's a Les Paul, it's really hard to get up here. They have done these strange cutouts. This one is... I don't know what this is for. Maybe just to release weight on the body. I don't know. There's no function otherwise. And then we have the belly cut that is... I mean... It starts here. So I don't know. How you're supposed to use... Yeah, it's the same thing when you stand up and use the strap. It ends up... I mean, I get the this edge of the belly cuts right at my belly. So I don't know. Maybe I'm constructed wrong. I don't know. Well, back to playability. I really like the neck. It plays really nice. But as I said, I mean, from this... Maybe 18th fret and up... You have to work quite a bit, so it can't give it more than a 7. Sorry. But otherwise, the neck is fantastic. Electronics, well, I say the same thing as I say in all my Harley Benton reviews. The volume knobs work. The pickups, no problem. The switches work. The tone knob. Same deal as always. It's full on or super mega off. There's no in between. It's like a two-way switch, basically. It takes away all the treble or just leaves it. So why don't remove it or exchange it for something that actually works? Electronics, it gets a 7. Okay, let's hear it. I'll start with a clean sound. And go through all the pickup combinations from bridge to middle to neck. Here we go. Some overdrive. Thank you. And finally, some high gain with added delay. Sounds, I gave it an 8. Well, no. Changed my mind. I gave it a 9. Sounds fantastic. I love the P90 pickups. They sound really good. They have this defined mid-range, defined high-end. It's everything I want in a pickup, in a guitar. It sounds really good. I like it. Can't stop playing it. And finally, I should mention that I think these are basically the same pickup. I don't think that's usually when you have like humbucker pickups, it's usually more output in the bridge pickup. I think these are kind of even, which makes in reality makes this one louder than this one, which I prefer. So suits me really well. Maybe that would be a problem for you. Finally, value, it's a 10. Of course, 10. It costs nothing. I got this as a B-stock guitar, so it costed even less. It plays phenomenal. It's phenomenal. That's hard to say. It sounds really good. So, I'm keeping this guitar. That's what's going to happen. That's good. And it's kind of thin as well for being a Les Paul, so that's nice. It's not so, and again with a thin neck, it's not so super mega heavy. It's kind of, I don't know, easy to get around with. So all in all, with a changed sound, it gets a 7.8. It's a really good guitar for no money at all. Get the one with the P90s if you like the sounds I like. It comes, there are versions of these with low output humbuckers, again from Wilkinson, and super high gain active pickups. I haven't tried any of them, but who knows if they are better than this one. I really like this one. If you couldn't tell, this has been the Swedish Guitar Nerd reviewing the SC Custom with P90s. Hope you found this useful. Try one for yourself. See you soon. Bye.